Hey everyone, Daniel Badnell here for Fitness FAQs. Hope you all had a safe and enjoyable Christmas and New Year's. In this video, I'm going to give you 5 quick bits of advice. And this is mainly for those that are new to training, but I'm sure that those that have been training for a while can still benefit from these quick tips. Let's get to it. First of all, let's talk about nutrition. Now, you really need to eat in accordance with your goals. So if you're looking to build muscle, you should be in a calorie surplus, looking to gradually increase your weight over time. If you're looking to decrease your body fat percentage, you should be on a calorie deficit, looking for your weight to decrease over time whilst you maintain your strength. I can't stress enough the importance of sticking to a style of nutrition that you can sustain week after week, month after month, for the long term. If you approach the mindset of going on a diet, that implies a short-term solution to a problem, and that usually involves people not being able to stick to it for a very long period of time. So find a style of nutrition that is effective for you and that you can see yourself sticking to for an indefinite period of time. Don't just try an approach that some guru recommends and you end up hating your life eating in that style. Experiment with different approaches and then stick to the one that increases your quality of life, maintains your level of performance, if not increasing it, and provides you with the body composition changes that you're looking for. Next up, let's talk about consistency. Now, guys, the biggest thing that I see is, especially people that are new to training, they're gonna go from not doing anything at all, trying to do, say, 5 to 6 workouts a week. They can do this for a short period of time, but once again, it comes back to that principle of not being able to sustain what they're doing. These are the type of people that will be okay for a few weeks, and then they're gonna fall off, not train for several months, and miss out on all the potential gains that they could be achieving in that time. Find something that you can stick to when it comes to the frequency per week. If that's 2 to 3 workouts a week, and you can do that year after year, you're gonna still get incredible results because you're doing something and you're following an approach whereby you can be consistent. In the gym, I can't stress enough the importance of using a full range of motion and completely dropping your ego. You're gonna get the fastest results when you use a full range of motion because you're getting more activation of your muscles and it's gonna be a more challenging movement pattern to work through a full range of motion as opposed to the person that has a massive ego for whatever reason it is and is concerned with how much weight they're lifting or how many reps they're doing at the expense of using a full range of motion. Be honest with yourself, make progress over time with a full range of motion and you'll be much better off for it, I can assure you. Let's continue talking about progression, and the key word I want you guys to take away from this video is incremental. A huge mistake beginners make when they start out training is they absolutely thrash themselves in the gym and they get a poor perception of what training should be. And in my opinion, progression via incremental improvements over time is what's going to allow you to keep training month after month, year after year, as opposed to burning yourself out by trying to sustain an intensity that's not realistic. So beginners, the best way to do this is to have a training journal, whether you're old school and use paper, or you track your training on your phone. This way you can see where you've been in the past, where you currently are now, and where you'd like to project yourself to be in the future. By tracking your training objectively like this, you're less subject to your emotional state on the day. If you don't have an objective goal for the day, say 3 sets of 10, you're more likely to quit when it hurts or quit when you feel like it. So by having an objective measurement there, you can push yourself beyond what you've previously done to get stronger and build muscle. But at the same time, you're doing it in an incremental fashion where it's realistic for you to keep making gradual progress over time. Lastly, let's talk about something that's so basic and simple. We all know it, but applying it time after time on a consistent basis will put you in a better position to make progress. If you don't take care of this variable, it's going to have a flow-on effect to everything else in your life. And you guys aren't stupid. You know what it's like when you don't get enough sleep. That's what I'm talking about right now, is sleep. So ensure that you get enough sleep each and every night to allow yourself to function properly. Getting your, say, 7 to 8 hours is going to put you in a very good position to be in a good mindset and be physically capable of achieving what you want to achieve. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Let's hit 2016 with some serious passion and drive to achieve what we want to achieve. I'll see you guys next week, Friday, for more videos.
Yeah, let's get it.
By the way, guys, how cool is this singlet?